Hey everyone, in this video we're going to be going through uniform flow, the simplest of the elementary flows. The steps here are going to appear a little circular, but they won't be for the remaining elementary flows that I'll be going through. So the first step is to specify the x and y components of velocity of uniform flow and the angle of attack alpha. Then we're going to determine the velocity potential phi sub u for uniform, by integrating the equation v is equal to del phi. And then finally, we're going to solve for the velocity components from this value, from phi u, and compare to the initial ones that we had specified from step one. And then finally, at the end of the video, we'll go through some Python slash MATLAB code for uniform flow to see how you can actually code up your own example. Because the flow is uniform, the velocity, including the magnitude and direction, needs to be the same at every single point in the flow. So we're going to define the freestream velocity, which is the magnitude, as v infinity, and we'll define the angle of attack, which is the direction, as alpha. So in the plot down here, we could see the velocity vector that has magnitude v infinity at an angle alpha from the x-axis, and we can define the vx and vy, so the x and the y components of this velocity, by dropping perpendiculars down to either the x-axis or to the y-axis, and we can solve these using v infinity and alpha. So for vx, we have v infinity cosine of alpha, and for vy, we have v infinity sine alpha. So from the velocity potential equation, we have v is equal to del phi, or the gradient of phi, which we can expand out as d phi dx in the i-hat direction plus d phi dy in the j-hat direction, which we can also then write as the x component here. So vx is equal to d phi dx, or the y component here as vy is equal to d phi dy. And we're trying to find phi, so we're going to integrate vx with respect to dx and vy with respect to dy. So that's what I'm showing here for the x and the y. So the first step is integral vx dx, and we just plug in from the previous whiteboard vx, which was v infinity cosine alpha, and we still have the dx here. And if we integrate that, because v infinity and alpha are both constants, all we have is v infinity cosine alpha x, and we are adding some function of y. Similarly for phi with respect to y, we have integral of vy dy is equal to, again, plugging in from the previous whiteboard, v infinity sine alpha dy, integrating, noting that these are constants, so we just get v infinity sine alpha y plus some function of x. And the reason we have the function of y and the function of x is because phi is a function of both x and y, but when we were integrating here, we were just integrating with respect to x or with respect to y. The way you can think about this making sense really quick is to say, well, now we have phi here, and we should be able to take the derivative of phi with respect to x and get vx. So if I take this here and take the derivative with respect to x, we get v infinity cosine alpha, and this function of y is not a function of x, so the derivative of that will be zero, and we do in fact get back vx is equal to v infinity cosine alpha. Same thing for the case with y. So how do we find out what those extra functions are, this f of y and g of x? I've rewritten these phi values from the previous whiteboard up here, and we can see that the first term in the second equation is a function of y. So the first term in the second equation right here is a function of y. So v infinity sine alpha y is f of y. And we can also see that the first term in the first equation, so this right up here, is a function of x. So v infinity cosine alpha x is g of x, which means that we can write the velocity potential for uniform flow as phi sub u is equal to v infinity cosine alpha x, that's the first term here, plus v infinity sine alpha y, the first term here. Something that might be slightly confusing is when you're looking at this velocity potential for uniform flow, you'll note that it's not uniform. It depends on where you are in space on the x and the y coordinate, and that's true, but the velocity from this uniform velocity potential is constant in space, does not depend on x and y. As we saw from before, our velocity components vx and vy were only dependent on v infinity and alpha. So finally, as the third step, we're going to complete the circle by making sure we get the original velocity components vx and vy from our velocity potential phi u from the previous whiteboard. So to do that, we're just going to use vx is equal to d phi u dx and vy is equal to d phi u dy, and we're taking the same, right, this is just phi u, the same thing in each of these partial derivatives, and you can see that since this is only a function of y, when you take the derivative with respect to x, it just goes to zero, and here, with respect to x, we return v infinity cosine alpha, and that is indeed our original vx. Similarly here, this is not a function of y, so this goes to zero, and this taking the derivative with respect to y gives us v infinity sine alpha, that also checks out. And so, in the other elementary flow videos that I'm going to do, I won't derive phi, but we'll still need to solve for vx and vy. And so that's why I did this circular logic here for the simplest uniform flow.
Now let's look at some code for the uniform flow. We're looking at my Python code here, but I also have this coded in MATLAB, and you'll be able to find both files on my website or GitHub with links in the video description. And note that if you want to run this, you'll also need my compute circulation function in the same folder. So first, we define the two knowns in this section here, which are the magnitude and direction of our freestream velocity vector, v infinity, and alpha, or the angle of attack. Next, we define the grid points that we'll be solving for the velocity at, so that's here. I'm just using a 10 by 10 grid so you can get the gist, but you can scale this to whatever size you want. And then down here, in this section, we're solving for the velocity vector components vx and vy, so vx and vy, at all the grid points, which is why we're looping over I and j, and these are based on the equations that we had written on the whiteboard before. This next section here just computes the circulation around a closed curve and prints the value to the console over here. It's not really relevant in the uniform flow case, but you'll see why it's relevant when we start talking about vortex flow. And finally down here, we create a plot of the velocity vectors at each grid point, and this is also called a quiver plot. And from this command right here, we are also plotting the ellipse or circle that we're computing the circulation around. Now we can run the program, first with our default angle of attack of 0 here. And so we'll press run, and a plot will pop up. And from this plot, we can see that the velocity vectors are shown in black and that they are all pointing in the positive x direction, as they should be. The computed circulation we can see down here is essentially equal to 0, as we would expect in this particular case. And now let's change the angle of attack to something like 30, perhaps, and we'll run it again. And we have a similar plot, but now we can see that the velocity vectors are pointing up and to the right at 30 degrees from the horizontal. And again, down here, we get that the circulation is essentially equal to 0, as we would expect. So this was a simple introduction to uniform flow and how to code up a program that computes the velocity at every grid point in a uniform flow. For a more complicated flow and the next logical step in this series, see my source or sync flow video. Thanks for watching.